From ABC News, this is Good Morning America. Now, from Times Square in New York, weekend anchors Bill Weir and Kate Snow.
Good morning, America. Nature's siege of the Southeast continues on this Sunday, September 26th. Well, we've all had one at some point, a bully boss, managers who insult and humiliate, who nitpick and criticize just about everything we do. You know who you are. But it is a very serious problem in the workplace, affecting mostly women who say these toxic bosses are literally making them sick.
Good are you? Do you have a brain? Do you want to keep this job? Shut up, listen, learn.
Hollywood has always relished telling stories right about there. Evil bosses and the employees who exact God. Revenge upon them.
Close that door or I'll shoot.
But not all abusive bosses are a work of fiction.
Every day was a constant fear of getting fired. Of what was going to be said to us, what we were going to be shown.
Joyce Polstra says she worked under an abusive boss for over a year at a telecommunications company in Texas. She says the strain became so great that it took a mental and physical toll.
I went into depression, lost about 25 pounds, had a little bald spot on the top of my head where my hair was falling out.
Workplace experts say stories like Joyce's are more common than you might think. According to a new book called The Allure of Toxic Leaders, most victims suffer helplessly as their bosses bully them and manipulate them emotionally.
This was meant to shock. It was meant to intimidate. It was meant to control.
For Joyce Polstra and two of her co-workers, there was a happy ending. They successfully sued the company they had worked for, winning a combined award of $275,000. But for countless others still working for toxic bosses, the abuse continues.
We turn now to Dr. Gary Namie, the director of Workplace Bullying and Trauma Institute and the author of The Bully at Work. Doctor, good morning.
Good morning, Bill.
I said at the top there, you know who you are. Do these people know who they are? Are these people who have decided it's better to be feared than loved, or are they just sadistic jerks and aren't aware of that?
No, they're sadistic jerks, some, and they are aware. But a lot of them are just soccer moms. You know, 58% of all the bullies are women. They're great people, but they're situational bullies. They just transform themselves in the workplace and get hyper-aggressive.
For what reason? To what end? For satisfaction? Is it a self-esteem issue?
Well, it gets rewarded, number one. It gets them promoted. And that's why I think women are as likely to be bullies as men. They just simply read the cues.
Now, when does bullying become harassment? I guess that's a fine
line way around.
There.
All harassment is bullying, but the illegal harassment is just a narrow slice of the big bullying picture. Bullying is three times more prevalent, for instance, than sexual harassment.
Wow. Now, people put up with it, you know, obvious reasons. They don't want to lose their job. But is there a deeper psychology that makes someone a victim of this more so than others?
What makes a target is they're non-confrontive, primarily. They either cannot or will not fight back. When someone comes at them, comes right in their face with aggression, they don't match it with aggression. Which is a good way to be, we thought, for a lot of folks, you know, turn right. The other cheek, but it gets you in trouble in a very hyper-aggressive, numbers-driven workplace.
So do you suggest, in fixing this, calling them on it? What steps can you take to fight it?
Well, the steps for fighting it for the individual are to name it, because naming it gives it power. It lets you know it's not you. Take time off for checking your mental health, your physical health. Check your legal status. Quarter of the cases provide the opportunity for legal action, or at least getting the employer to pay attention, and then expose the bully. If you don't expose the bully, then what you're going to do is you're going to risk your own health harm. And as the women talked about their depression, it's very prevalent to have clinical depression or even PTSD. Right. As you're talking about the hurricane, the PTSD, the traumatization.
Right.
So you do it for your own health sake.
Okay. Dr. Gary Namie, thank you. Your book is The Bully at Work. We appreciate the information.
Thank you.